Welcome to Artistry Collaborative. My name is Joanne, and I'm so glad you joined me today. If you're new to my channel, well, welcome. I hope you stick around, and if you see what you like, maybe become a subscriber, because I would love for you to join my YouTube family. And to my subscribers, well, mwah, you know I love you so, so, so much. Here at Artistry Collaborative, we are the home of Try Lab, because, well, all we want you to do is try. That's all it takes. I love inspiring creativity. I love giving you ideas and tips and techniques. We try it all here. Today we have three upcycled, repurposed items. One was a family throwaway and a couple of things that I got from Goodwill. So come and let's create these together. Okay, so this is from my daughter's grandmother, and this was, I think she used it for sewing, but it was all this wood color, and I decided not to paint the inside, but I did use Rust-Oleum 2X, it has primer in it, and did a coat of that, and this is going to go in our bathroom. So, I knew I wanted to do something here, but I wasn't really sure. I was going to do like a mosaic, and I don't know. But, I found this paper that was left over from a project we did. We repurposed a chest that we found at Goodwill. And it goes with the theme of the bathroom, because it's very... beachy, sea-like, not exactly nautical. And then I have this trim that I'm going to put in here. So, I am going to cut this to the size that I want, and I will Mod Podge it down, and then I will cut these to trim it. I'm going to paint it in silver, because there's silver running through this. And then we'll see what else we're going to do. I'm not sure. But this is what we got so far. Okay, so I put this down with Mod Podge, and then I put a layer over it. I also put it on the back and on the sides. So you'll see that when it's fully covered. And I bought this molding from Home Depot. I got like 6 feet or 8 feet, and now I used my miter saw and made the four sides. And now I'm using this decor extreme sheen metallic paint. It's in silver, and I am just coating all three sides on here. And then once that is dried, I am going to use E6000 and glue that on there, and then wait overnight. So I'm going to do that, and I'll be back. So this is what it looks like with that on it. And now I'm going to open up, it's plastic wood. I actually put the thing on backwards. Just to fill in the gaps here. And it's just like a paste. Oh, it's dried out. Oh, that's not good. Okay, so here is it. Here it is with the molding. Now we've got to just fill in the gaps. I was going to use wood putty, but it's all dried out. So I'm just using the lightweight spackling just to fill it in. So I'm going to give you a close-up. And you just take the spackling and just... squeeze it in the space that's there. And then you want to clean it up really good. You can always sand it off later, but... and then once this is dried, I will touch it up with the same paint that I painted the molding with. Alright, so now while that's drying, this still is boring to me. So I picked up these, which is I was originally going to put in the middle, and I'm thinking of lining them up, like cutting out the squares, and lining them up that way. So I'm going to try it, see if I like it. If I like it, then I will tacky glue it down. I will be covering up the holes, so I'm going to have to find the holes again, but that's okay. I'll figure that out. Actually, I'll just make sure I know where the holes are. And that one I'll be able to find. Okay. Okay, so I am really liking this. It's pretty. But there is little edges here. And luckily, this went off the edge a little bit. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to fill this in with these other scrap pieces that I have. But I don't, like, if you notice, there's like a short and a long and a short and a long. So I'm going to try to make it look like it just was a continuation. Like this. Yeah. So that works really well. And then I'll just trim that. So I'm going to fill all these gaps in and I'll be back. So this is all finished. And now we're going to put the handle in it. So I'm seeing where it comes out, and I'm just going to make an ever so small cut, just a little X. I'm going to take it out. You have the nut, you have that. This is going to go through here. So it came through, then you put the washer, and you put the nut. And that's all set, like that. Now, I was going to put something here. I was going to like make a sea, like put, I love seahorses, I was going to put some seahorses. I don't think I'm going to put anything. It's just really pretty. You could put a simple wreath of greenery on there. That might look cute. But I think I'm going to just leave it as it is for now. Okay, so it came through. Then you put the washer. And you put the nut. And that's all set. Like that. Now, I was going to put something here. I was going to like make a sea, like put, I love seahorses. I was going to put some seahorses. I don't think I'm going to put anything. It's just really pretty. You could put a simple wreath of greenery on there. That might look cute. But I think I'm going to just leave it as it is for now. Okay. So, I did spray paint these silver. And just a trick, when you want to, you want the nails to match, the screws to match. I just put them in a piece of wood and then spray painted them in there. Now, the thing is, I need to put some of this leftover here. So, I don't want this like this. So, I'm going to add a little bit more on there and then I'll put the hinges on. And there you go. All finished. I love it. So I found this star at Goodwill, and we're going to use the Waverly in white and agave, and we're going to try to create an ombre effect. Okay, so this is all painted, and now I'm going to start with straight agave. I'm going to start out dark and go light. You could go dark and go in light. What I'm going to do is just take some of the agave. Actually, you know what? I think I'm just going to use what's in here. So I'm going to, this brush is done.
gonna paint this, and then I'm gonna add some white. Mix that in, do a little bit more. Let me paint this and I'll be back. Okay, so there's just a little bit left in here. So what I'm gonna do is take some white. Obviously I painted this straight agave, and I'm gonna put some white in there, and we're gonna lighten it a little bit, and then we're gonna take that and start to feather this out. So I'll paint this and I'll be back. Right, so now I'm gonna take a little bit more white, add that in, and again it's a very gradual gradation. So mix that and then go to the next level. Now I will say that you should probably do this on a palette. It's very hard to see how well it's mixed. So a palette, a cup, I'm not being very scientific about it, but you do want to see the change in the gradation. Okay, so all I have left is the tips, but I'm gonna use all of this to do the background in that, because you can see it. So I'm gonna do it in this very light color.
Okay, so now that it's finished, I'm looking at some of my pins, because I wanted to decorate the middle, and then we're going to use different rhinestones and pearls. That'll come out and go out on the spokes. I finally ended up using a star. Came from an old piece of jewelry, so that's what I ended up using. But here I am just picking through the different rhinestones that I have, and I'm using a variety of teal and aqua blue pearl, and some iridescent rhinestones. And I'm just putting them around, starting with the largest from the center, and then working to the tips with smaller and smaller rhinestones until I get to the very tip, and then I use a diamond shape rhinestone that we had. So that's all that there is to this, and I will show you the finished product in a minute. And here you see the gradation even on the rhinestones, and now I'm taking some E6000, and this is the star piece that I found, so I'm putting that on the back of it, and we'll put that in the middle. I did use tacky glue on the back of those rhinestones. Even though they are tacky, they do have some kind of glue behind it. I did use tacky glue to reinsure that they stay there. So here I am just putting the middle down, and then there's a piece that sits in there, and I'm just using the E6000. So I love this. This is going on my wall, and I hope that you liked it too.
So I bought this lamp at Goodwill for $7.99, and then the challenge was getting a lampshade. I had bought one at Goodwill, it was too big. I bought one at Walmart, it was too small, and I finally found this one, and it's perfect, except that it's beige. So, one of the first things I was going to do, and I still might, I don't know, is I was going to decoupage some flowers on the bottom here. But I don't want to take away too much because this is very pretty. I don't know if you can see it, but it's pearl iridescent, so I really like that. But I want this to be very boho and chic, and so I am going to paint this with chalk paint. We'll let that dry. Then we're going to cover it with lace and maybe flowers, maybe pearls. Who knows? We're going to have some fun. Okay, so it is white. And now I have this lace that I have. I have a whole ream of it. And I am going to glue it around the edge. Now, I'm thinking of layering it all the way up. But I'm going to put the first one around. And then I will see if I want to do that. So, let me try that, and I'll be back. We'll put some glue. Put this on here. I'm not sure if you can see it, but it's all embellished with iridescent sequins, so it's just very pretty and dainty. And I hope it gives me the look I'm going for. Now what I'm gonna have to do is kind of pleat it along the way because it will pucker. So all I'll do is just gather a little bit more, put this along the edge, and then just gather it. That and I'll be back. Okay, so I really love this. I don't think I want more than that. So I'm thinking of adding some flowers up here. Now I have this. My room is teal. This is more aqua. So I didn't know if I want to put, I don't know. So many choices. I could put something like that, which is very sweet. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. So, what I'm going to do is find the back. Here's the back. And I'm going to just glue. At the top. Maybe I'll just do that. Oh, yeah. Alright. Can you see this? Yeah. So what I'm going to do is where every rib is, I'm going to put a rosette. And then this will just hang down. So I'll go all the way around. I may put a dot of glue just to hold them down. I would like to add some color, but I don't know what. I'm going to look amongst my things and see what I find.
So I thought I was going to add color, but then I found this roll of pearls I got from the Dollar Tree. And there's like 5 strands, I believe. So I'm going to put strips. Originally, I didn't think I had enough to do every rib, so I did every other. But then I found in my stash another roll, so I ended up doing every rib. And all I did was glue it underneath the rosette at the top, which of course you can't see because of my arm, and then measured it to the bottom. And then I put a bead of glue down the rib, the middle set of pearls. Like I said, there's 5 lines of pearls. And then I just let that sit on there. So now this is, yeah, after doing this I realized I needed to do down the whole center. So I'm lifting it back up. My arm is in the way. I apologize for that. But all I'm doing is lining a bead of glue down the center rib, and then I'm laying the beads on top of it. And so I'm doing that all the way around. So here it is complete. I have the pearls on every rib. And I just love it. It's just so sweet. I'd like it to have color, but I think it works just the way it is. So thank you so much for tuning in. Please, if you would like, please hit that subscribe button and the bell, so every time I upload a new video, you'll be notified. And as we say, just keep on creating.